Hello and welcome to this sixth tutorial in a series made for 24HourAnswers.com where we learn to be a better programmer. This time we'll be looking at a tutorial on handling user input in your programs and discussing how you might utilise this in a few simple programs. We have already seen and utilised quite extensively the system pause command. This just breaks the program and waits for any key to be pressed by the user. This, obviously, is a very coarse grain of control. All it allows us to do is pause until the next key is pressed. It may be appropriate for breaking up, say, the output of a report as it gets displayed on screen, or waiting before a console program moves on to the next section. However, in a real console application, you would more likely want to read actual input from the user's keyboard. I'm sure you can come up with many situations where this might be the case, but we're going to focus on the example of a menu for a simple application, which will draw on the things we've learnt over the past few lessons. Input, in general terms, can be considered as coming from a source. This source is known as a stream, and one example is the keyboard input stream. This is known as standard input, or STDIN, and is provided by default by the C library if you include the STDIO, standard input, header file. Another header file we'll use is CONIO, console in out, and this gives us access to the very useful getch function. In this tutorial, I'm going to focus on three particular methods you can use to different effects. The first of these is getch, which will get a character from the keyboard. You can, I'm sure, see the immediate limitations of the inability to easily get, say, a number outside of the range 0 to 9 or a multi-character string. For this reason, we will also examine two other methods: scanfs, which will allow you to read a particular type of input rather than just a single character, and then fgets, which allows you to read an entire line of input. We want to use the keyboard as our stream, and so getch will read from the stream stdin, standard input. When the program hits this line, execution will stop until the keyboard key is pressed. The value of that key is then assigned to the char variable input. Remember that although getch returns an integer, this type is cross-compatible with the char. However, please take care and be aware of the fact that the integer value of input is different to the character value. Do not test that the input character has a value of 1, as I have done in this indicated section, and instead check that it has a value of the character 1. At this point, you should be able to interpret this program. It asks the user to enter a number, and if they enter 1, it tells them that they entered the number 1, otherwise it tells them what they entered instead. Simple and not very useful. Beneath this, we see an infinite loop that forms the menu option input system. The first thing in this loop is the rewind statement called on standard in. This clears the standard input buffer. After this, the user has a list of menu options given with the printf statements. Next, we create a switch statement around the output of getch. The switch statement allows you to essentially define a series of if statements. When the user inputs a menu option, the switch statement will jump to the case that equals the value of the input. Menu options 3 and 4 are the simplest, so I'll cover them first. 3 will break out of the case statement and do nothing. As a result, the code loops back to the start of our infinite loop and prints the menu again. Option 4 quits out of the method, and since this is the main method, the program's execution will stop. The more observant amongst you will notice the default case just above the case 3 statement. This simply prints invalid string. However, because there's no break statement or return statement at the end of the default case, execution will continue and flow into case 3, where the switch statement breaks and the whole menu input resumes again. The effect and purpose of this is to catch invalid user inputs, something you should always think about in writing your programs. Any value not handled by another case will be handled by the default case. As a result, we can catch invalid inputs that aren't in the menu, like the number 5 or a letter, for instance. Using the default case as a kind of catch-all enables our program to be more robust and handle unexpected input correctly. Case 1 and 2 demonstrate the second way of taking input via the scanfs and fgets functions. When we read the number, we make use of scanfs. The first parameter to scanfs is the input type, which we are expecting to receive from the keyboard. The second parameter, or parameters, is the variables to which we wish to assign each of these inputs. I say variables because you could pass multiple tokens in the first argument, and then the corresponding number of variables could be passed after it, to fill each of those with a value. Do not worry so much about the ampersand symbol before the number variable here. It is related to the topic of pointers. For now, consider that the and symbol means we are not passing the value of a number, but its address in memory as the parameter. In case 2, we are going to work with a string input. fgets is what allows us to do this, as it reads an entire line of keyboard input. The first parameter is the variable to store that input in, which in our case is an array of 1,000 characters. The second input, the number 1,000, tells the program not to read any more than 1,000 characters of input or until the user presses enter. Finally, we instruct the program where to take the input from. We use standard in again, as we want to read the keyboard input rather than a line from a file, for example. We then print the string with the %s token. And that's about all there is to keyboard input at this level. And run the program now to demonstrate the code paths. So here we're prompted to enter a number. If we enter 2, we're told that we entered 2 instead of 1, and then we're given the menu. Here I can enter a number by pressing 1, where I'm prompted to enter a number. So I'll enter 456 and press enter. The program then tells me what my output is, and I can come back to the menu and enter a string, which I'll do here. Again, the program tells me what the string was. Obviously, you can see how you could create more complex programs with this by processing the input of the string or assigning it to a meaningful variable. Finally, we can print the menu again before we quit and the program will end. Try playing with this program and see what interesting changes you can make. Particularly try to modify it to take several integers input in case 1 and then show the user the sum of those variables. You may even try what we've learned before about arrays to achieve this. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to post them below.